All right, somebody on Facebook was asking me how we designed our chute, our sheep chute. As you can see, there are scrap pieces of wood associated to this thing, and everything can be bought at your local home supply store. But essentially, we made little ground. We took these old pickets that we had lying around, kind of used it to make a skeleton out of everything because they're pressure treated. On the ground, there's pickets that end up being part of the floor essentially. We used angle brackets to hook everything relatively securely. I just added those two because the sheep broke through that. 2 8-foot by 3 feet corrugated vinyl panels. Makes them slip through easily, but it's bendy, so it's kind of not so good. We have these little bracing struts. I probably need more of them because the sheep do push the sides out when they don't want to be in the chute, or if they're trying to turn around, which some of them do. That is our staging area, the shed. We have an old pallet here, and at our hay place, if we can buy not this robust of a pallet, but plastic pallets for $5 a piece, and we use them for walls and things. You can see a cow there, a cattle panel. You can see the other half of that, whatever that wood thing is, and that we're using for a gate. We did that over there because the lambs were getting out the corner. You can hear the energizer pumping through. And then we took, essentially, when they roll out of this gate, and I'll run through it, when they roll out of this gate, they are confined in this area here. We have a trough that's on its side right now that we give them kibble for good behavior and water. And so they come out here, but we separate the two. We have a staging area and then the end area. And we just took what we had. We have a gate here. I built all these interior fencing. By the way, this cord, electric rope, is crazy expensive, but it's really good. It's easy. Well, the nice thing about it, it's easy to work with. So I have semi-permanent, and then I made essentially doors on 2x2s that I could take down, put up, to connect everything together. I gotta get their minerals to them. Anyway, so we get this is the staging area for the sheep. They come in here. We bring them through this. In here, we don't even close this gate because they, once they get in here, they kind of know the drill. But if they're misbehaving, we'll pack them all in here. We got 33 sheep coming through here. Here's our old birthing jugs made out of those $5 pallets that we get at the hay place, Murphy's Hay in Lewisburg. And this is for new mothers and their lambs to get acquainted. You can shut this like a gate and keep them there for a day or two, and then they're much happier. Okay, so you can, the sheep come in here. We let, out of our 33 sheep, we let 5 in at a time. Monica usually drives them. Come in here. Excuse me. Got one person on the outside and one person on the inside. We use these old beehives. We have a lot of old bee equipment that we really need to make use of again. For a table over there that we put any kind of medication, shots, anything we need to do. Run the sheep in here. Monica stands back here. And then I lean over and inject into their mouth or in their side or whatever needs to be done. And Monica does the same for the back ones. And often she'll have to do it because they don't like things stuck in their mouths when they haven't asked for it. And they'll back up and they'll plow into each other. Anyway, I use this stick here just to keep the gate from flying open because the sheep know that it opens. But this is the gate. It's on a hinge. I'll show you guys in a minute. This video is too long. I'm not going to edit it. And I need to clean up this bee equipment. Anyway, So I usually stand here working along the side, working along this side here, and then this gate swings open and shut. And then when the sheep come in, I just put a stake in the way. Probably a better system. Anyway, that's our setup. It works. Works great. Of course, we block off that pallet as well. So, anyway, that's our SheepChute. Yeehaw.